So what is telematics? Let's just refresh our minds for a second and talk about what are the elements that make up telematics today. Well, the first element is around data gathering. So that is a device in a vehicle that connects to the systems of the vehicle that retrieves all of the signal data that the vehicle is generating. So it could be things like the speed, it could be engine light information, it could be faults that are happening in the vehicle, it could be accelerations, it could be position of the vehicle, taking all that data, recording it, and then moving that data up to the cloud. And that's an important part of what telematics is getting that data up to the cloud. The next element is fleet management, which is the services, you know, usually cloud-based software as a service that you offer to fleets in order for them to take that data and do something useful with that data. So, you know, rules engines, reporting, analysis of the data, route planning, visualization on maps, that kind of stuff. The next element is around analytics. It is the ability to take that data at scale, use machine learning on the data, anonymize the data, and then benchmark. So let's compare how one fleet performs in terms of safety compared to another fleet so that we can improve that fleet. Let's figure out which are the most common places that people congregate, or let's understand the way that I structured my routes, whether that is effective for me to do the job that I need to do. It is really bigger picture analytics, combining, you know, the aggregation of all of the fleet's data together with comparing that and benchmarking that against my own. And then finally, there's the marketplace, which is opening this data up to the ecosystem, making sure that any company that produces systems or services or hardware that relate in some way to transportation can plug into this ecosystem, can use the data, can leverage the data, can have their data pushed into the My Geotab systems. That's really the marketplace element. So it's broken into these four components, all very important. Now, when we talk about OEM telematics, what we're talking about is the very first element, data gathering. Almost none of the OEMs today, the vehicle manufacturers, have their own fleet management capability. Some of them might have a very simple system to show some stuff on a map, but they really have just scratched the surface of fleet management. They're really focused on the data gathering element. And frankly, there's nothing that makes more sense than getting the data directly from the OEM, in that you don't have to worry about the logistics of plugging in hardware. You don't have the extra cost of the hardware. It's already installed by the OEM. It's needed by the OEM. And so for sure, the data gathering element belongs to the OEMs. Geotab, as you know, has very extensive partnerships on the OEM side. A whole lot more being announced soon, but we have already 20, 30 partnerships, and they include partnerships with Ford to use their connected car data, GM, Volvo, Mack, just to name a few. See, one of the problems that vehicle OEMs have is around what we call the single pane of glass. It is very, very rare to find a business, especially a larger business, where every single vehicle in the fleet is of one vehicle type, right? They tend to come from multiple manufacturers. Nobody wants to only be able to buy GMs or only be able to buy Fords. There are certain specialized circumstances where you may need other vehicles. And so the OEMs need to be able to offer one single pane of glass to allow people to see and manage and use telematics for those fleets. In addition, what about the older vehicles that are not connected? OEMs need to have a solution to allow those older vehicles, in fact, to be connected too. You want to be able to have that single pane of glass and get everything in one place. Now, there is an unfortunate set of limitations we just need to understand around the first version of OEM telematics that I'd like to spend a little bit of time talking about so we don't make a mistake. So first of all, it is really important to know that Geotab wants to see hardware gone. In the long run, there is no place for a Go device. It has to be part and parcel of the vehicle and its relationships with the OEMs and its connectivity to the OEMs. But understand that more than 15 years of engineering has gone into our hardware, and there are many important lessons that we've learned along the way. We are taking those lessons to every single OEM who will listen to us, and we are trying to help them build a better OEM product so that we can get better data for our telematics, and so that customers don't have to choose between OEM telematics and high quality data. The biggest limitation today with OEM telematics is what we call curve logic. Curve logic is our algorithm for how we record data in the vehicle. And so what it does is it optimizes which sets of data we log. We don't just log everything. It's impossible. There's too much data to transport over the cell phone network for us to log every piece of data. So we selectively use an algorithm to pick and choose which data. So for example, if you're speeding, if we only logged once every 2 or 3 minutes, we may be speeding on the highway and we may miss a speeding infraction. And that could cause a serious problem because maybe there's an accident and there needs to be some reconstruction. Geotab's algorithm records the data in high resolution and then picks the most meaningful data. It'll pick the top of the speeding curve, the bottom of the speeding curve. It'll pick the corner when you turn. It'll pick the maximum and minimum voltages. And this is really the power of curve logic. Many of the OEMs, in fact, if not all, today, still log on a timed basis. And when you try and apply that to the Geotab rules engine, which says, I want to know if Neil was speeding for more than 20 seconds, how can I possibly know if Neil's speeding for more than 20 seconds if my vehicle is only logging once every 2 minutes? I can speed for 20 seconds and it can be in between the two logs and it'll never get picked up. I may get lucky, it does get caught, but I can't guarantee it. And I can't tell you for how long that speeding happened. And so really we have some limitations there. So we're urging OEMs, we're making available, in fact, it's available today on a GitHub website, an open algorithm that OEMs can use. And many of the OEMs have expressed strong interest and will be building that in future products. So that's the first problem we have to grapple with. Now, there's certain use cases, frankly, where that really doesn't matter. If I don't need to do those kind of speeding rules, if I put in a speeding rule, for example, that says I need to know if Neil speeds for more than 2 minutes, then it'll work because I know I'm logging every 2 minutes. If I get two logs in a row of Neil speeding, I am sure that Neil just sped for 2 minutes, at least 2 minutes, that is. So there are some ways around that, and the use case very much depends on what customers are looking for. The next big problem is IOX support. OEMs do not have the ability to plug in any of the IOXs that our marketplace has to offer, Geotab and our marketplace. There are 30, 40, 50 different IOXs that you can buy today. You know that IOXs are a little hub, an IoT hub for your vehicle. And so being able to plug in these IOXs to do things like driver identification, or you want to have a Wi-Fi hotspot, or you want to have a camera system, or you want to do Bluetooth tracking, or you want to have a switch, or you want to tie to the PTO, or you want to be able to log temperature, or you want to do reefer temperature monitoring or tire pressure monitoring, you can do this all with IOXs, and they can daisy chain. You can have many of them. And again, we've spoken to the OEMs and we've said, those who are interested, it's not charged for by Geotab. We believe in open standards at our core. We will offer those standards, that information, the knowledge to help OEMs get there so that you can have the benefits of this IOX support. The next and final point, the next element that is missing, is some critical data elements. There are very big inconsistencies between the quality of the data from different OEMs. There are OEMs that we deal with that the quality of the data is not there, especially when you're dealing with something like electric vehicles, where in order to be good at managing electric vehicles, we need to know a bunch of things. We need to know state of charge. We need to know how quickly the energy is depleting. We need to know when the vehicle's charging. Ideally, we need to be able to turn charging on or off. And all these elements are missing from most, if not all, of the APIs that are available today. And so that really is the problem. Now, we want to see this succeed. Geotab is doing everything in its power to help everybody get to a place where OEM has taken over. And we're working with the OEMs. We're working with partners. We just need to make sure in this interim stage that the customer is not disappointed when they put OEM in, that they realize the differences between what they get with Geotab and what they get with the OEM, and that is going to improve over time. And that's the good news. But they mustn't be disappointed in certain use cases that cannot be done with the OEM telematics today. But the beauty is you have flexibility. You can start with some OEM, you can ramp it up, you can try it out, you can see if it works for you, you can change to Geotab, you can change back. And that really is the fundamental open approach that we believe in. And that's what is good for customers in the long run. Thank you.